Commitment means to turn on some generator units to cover a certain load, while decommitment means to turn off some units which have higher generation cost. So unit commitment is to identify the optimal schedule for all units so that the total generation cost is minimized. This takes into account the constraints present in the individual generators as well as the loads. A number of techniques have been proposed to solve the unit commitment problem. And among these, to mention a few approaches used in the solution of unit commitment problem, we have the linear programming approach, then the Laclaurin relaxation approach, interior point method. Further, we do have intelligent techniques like genetic algorithm or PSO being applied for the unit commitment problem. And in all these problems, each literature will differ the way in which or the number of constraints taken into accounts, and the number of generators that is deciding the type of problem. It can range from 6 unit to 10 unit. And in sub-problems, we will also have forecasted load, maybe for 12 hours or 24 hours. Therein, the job of the GenCo would be to perform unit commitment for the day-ahead market in such a way that the profit is maximized. And for the units to operate, we have constraints, and additional cost other than the fuel cost. This includes the startup cost, shutdown cost, spinning reserve, then ramp time, and many more. And you should understand that unit commitment is not a simple problem like turning on a switch and use them whenever you like. So it involves the commitment of units, wherein you need to consider the forecasted load and the first priority will be to minimize the cost. And naturally, the generators which are expensive to run, they will be decommitted first. So as I was telling, if a unit is on, we will designate it with 1, and in case it is off, it is designated as 0. So in unit commitment, you will find representations like 01101 or 001. So for example, in this case 00101. So it is the this refers to a condition of having 3 units on in a 5 unit problem. And once we decide which units are on, thereafterwards the next step would be to solve the economic dispatch for the units which are turned on. And the question comes, how does this commitment happen? Say 01101. So it means that it just represents for every hour based upon the demand, some new units are going to be turned on or some other units are going to be shut down. So for each combination for a given hour, we need to solve the economic dispatch in such a way that the fuel cost is minimized. So economic dispatch is the next step after unit commitment. A general Lagrangian relaxation problem will be of the form, minimize a function f. F is equal to something into u1 plus something into u2. So this is the general shape of a Lagrangian problem wherein you need to minimize the function f. And we do have constraints. See, as given, w is equal to phi minus x1 u1. So that is an equality constraint, and we do have inequality constraints, x1 between 0 to 10, x2 between 0 to 10. And as far as this problem, you may take only 2 values, either 0 or 1 for our problem. So the mathematical background of Lagrangian relaxation, the researcher needs to be familiar, then only you can work on this problem. So this is one primer task which we do at expert agencies for people working on unit commitment. Further research, if you want to do on unit commitment, you can work on task like this. The Lagrangian relaxation, no? You have lambda. Mathematically, you should remember that it involves a factor called lambda. So for finding the lambda, you can use some intelligent techniques like PSO or genetic algorithm. So it becomes LR method assisted with some intelligent technique. So this is one area wherein you can do research. And further in this slide, how the mathematical basis is worked out for LR for Lagrangian relaxation is shown here. So students interested in working on unit commitment, you can first get trained on how to develop MATLAB programs using LR technique for unit commitment. In the second stage of your research, you can extend the same problem with tools like particle swarm optimization or genetic algorithm. And further, you may even go for hybrid techniques, and you can compare the performance of various algorithms. And test systems also, you may start with smaller systems, 3-unit system or 6-unit system, and you can go for the standard 10-unit commitment system. Further extension, you may go for 100-unit or 1000-units also. Thank you, friends.